Hello you guys. So today I wanted to make a nice and cozy vlog style of video. I'm just going to show you things that are comfy and soothing to the soul and things that bring me a lot of joy and comfort. So let's begin. So here's one of the things that brings me joy is decorating for different seasons. This one is for turkey season right now for Thanksgiving. I've had this pillow for quite many years now. And then same thing with these pillowcases. These are new ones, purple ones, kind of for to tie in a little bit of Halloween too. And you guys, this is the blanket that I absolutely adore. It's quite an investment. It is not a real fur, obviously, but it's heavy and it's such a great, great quality. It's always so soothing to watch the curtains go back and forth. It really reminds me of my childhood when we would do like breezy afternoons and mornings. Style of curtains. So this is double layered sheer curtain and it lets some light in, but it also kind of creates privacy. My window is not the cleanest, but me and Mila made these pressed leaves, and I think in spring I will definitely do more of flowers or just green leaves maybe. And these are the roses from our yard. They both smell incredible. So this one is called Firefighter, and this one is called Bolero or something. This one smells the most amazing. So this is my kitchen shelf. It's a little bit busy, but I kind of like it. I have these two cutesy birds here. And I got this plate. Okay, so I finally have time to make myself some coffee. I actually wanted to show you today, guys, this one. It's called the Sonoral Bean. And I have a code for you and 10% off, and it's not sponsored. Nope. This is actually one of our family members. He is a wonderful young man. He started his own coffee company. He's located in Arizona, and his coffee is amazing. Is ready. So I'm trying to pick an outfit for today, and I'm thinking between these two cardigans. I've never owned a long cardigan until this fall, and I went to Kohl's and I found this one first, and I loved it so much. I love how versatile it is, and it's just like a little thin layer. This one is quite thin. By the way, this is the look without the belt. I feel like the belt kind of cinches the waist a little bit more. This is more relaxed look. So this is the second cardigan, and it's much more plush. So it's actually like pretty much a winter almost clothes in our climate. It gives me like this little cuddly sensation, and it's so cozy, and I feel like it's just the colors are really pretty on me. I do like it better with the belts. Okay, so this is the look with the belts. I do feel like it just kind of gives me a better shape overall. And for jewelry, I chose these little kind of flower earrings and my little three birds necklace that I've owned for a while. Okay, so that's my look today. I wanted to record some of the beautiful leaves turning. It's definitely late fall, just about to fall down, I think. Looks so, so beautiful. Okay, so picking some books for Mila to read. I always feel like it's one of the cutest things you can do is to go to a library and pick some interesting books. Usually I bring my child with me, but today is just you and me. Let's see. Oh yeah, definitely a favorite. Llama Llama Holiday Drama. Okay, this is one of my favorite characters, is Llama Llama. So is Mila's. I've watched all of the cartoons, read all the books. I don't own any of these books because we constantly get them from the library. And they have awesome ones for seasons. So I might take this one actually. The Nutcracker might be a little bit too scary right now for this age for us. Cowboy Christmas, interesting, cute pictures. Oh God, cows instead of deer. That might be actually quite funny. I might grab this one too. Okay, so here are some of the books that I picked. Atlantis, The Lost Empire, looked pretty nice. Then we have this Fancy Nancy Fabulous Fashion Boutique. Mila loves Fancy Nancy. It's very colorful, very a beautiful character, honestly. Okay, then I got another Fancy Nancy. This one's Aspiring Artist. I like this character too. Her little neighbor, Mrs. Divine. She's always very kind of outgoing and very ladylike. Love that character. Then I ended up taking this Cowboy Christmas. It looked funny. I love sometimes books that are literally something to laugh about, so not as serious. And I did take Llama Llama Holiday Drama. Okay, so now I'm in Marshall's, and I'm really here not for clothing, but I found a few pieces that I'm really thinking about now. Like, look at this one. Isn't this so pretty? I love that it's so shiny. Okay, also the green. I just want something that I can wear maybe the whole season. I love this new neckline. I have not seen that before done, so it's kind of exciting. And this one has beautiful flowers, probably like a Christmas flower. Quite nice looking. I love me all the beads. Any type of pearls or beads always look good. So I'm gonna sit down so people don't stare at me. I'm actually here to get like a platter for Christmas. I've started decorating my shelving in the kitchen, and I wanted to get like a big plate that I can display just on the stand on the shelf. So that's what I'm gonna look for right now. Oh my gosh, look at all the prettiness here, you guys. I thought the plates would be here, but they're not here for Christmas. Okay, so maybe these are the plates. I see one there, but I wanted something a little bit more elaborate. Oh, wait a second, let me see. So maybe that's it. Oh, it's plastic. I did not want the plastic one. How cute are some of these cups though, you guys? You're pretty. Oh my goodness, look at this one. Look at this one with the reindeer sticking out. Okay, this is not what I was looking for, but I think Mila's gonna love this one. Okay, so they do have a ton of really cute Christmas stuff, like these little hand towels. This one's a little bit kind of childish, but which I actually like sometimes, a little cute scene. But I would get something more like this. That's kind of a classic look. Okay. They do have a bunch of these kind of blankets, which are adorable, but honestly, I haven't... Ooh, that's a nice sound, by the way. I have invested into that huge blanket a couple years ago, like the faux fur. And now I cannot buy any more blankets because that is my blanket for Christmas season, for like winter. Okay, this is so luxurious. It feels so good, so soft. Oh my goodness, I gotta get going. So I did come here on the weekend. It's super busy. I mean, very, very busy here. So I might have to come back another time, and it looks like they're just restocking for Christmas, so they don't really have any of those big plates, which is a bummer. So I'll just be back to look for it next time. I'm not gonna take the cup. Okay, so now I have time to make our dinner, and today I'm going to be making spaghetti squash with turkey and mushrooms, and I'm also going to make Marion berry pie. So I'm going to show you the final results in just a minute. While the stove is warming up, preheating, I'm going to rub in some oil and spices into our spaghetti squash. If you've never tried spaghetti squash, I would highly recommend you trying this recipe. I have a video that I made a few years back, and it's the most delicious recipe for spaghetti squash. I promise you, you're going to be obsessed with it. And here our spaghetti squash is baking as well. So while we're waiting for all of the baking to be finished, I'm making myself a delicious snack. You know how in America everybody's obsessed with peanut butter? So I grew up on a buttered toast with jam. I love this one with boysenberry. It's lately my favorite one. So all of my childhood, the most delicious dessert was this. Toast with butter and with jam on it. You have to lick the spoon because, you know, you're not savage, right? Look at this delicious food. It is the best tasting, the most mellow flavored snack ever. It tastes like my childhood right away. And it doesn't matter which jam you put on, it always tastes amazing. You know, this has always been my seat because I enjoy looking out the windows. So this is my view all the time. I watch the birds right there in the bird feeder. From this angle, I can see my beautiful vegetable garden. And so recently I've noticed that while I love to look at the garden, my back is fully to the rest of the house, so I cannot see anything behind me. But Daryl's position is always at the head of the table where he can see outside behind me. So his back is always towards the window in the corner, so he can see everything. And I've recently realized that's how my father always used to sit, and I sometimes wonder if the head of the household, however the person is, I wonder if it's like a responsibility that you just innately take on as a protector, and you just want to sit where you can see and observe, and then the rest of your family sits around And for me, it makes sense because I run to the kitchen all the time, back and forth, just to bring something. So it makes sense for me to sit here too, so I don't have to keep walking around. I wonder if it's a thing in your family. Have you noticed that the person who is like the protector of your family, who is the head of the household, so to say, do they feel the same way? Have you noticed they position themselves in situation without realizing it, sort of in a protective state? I've noticed that it's such a kind of sweet thing, actually. This spot is one of my favorite things to look at every day out of the window. The roses, everything is on its last leg, however. Cute little bee buzzing around. Moments this season for color. So a lot of color is going to disappear very soon. Shoes on this looks incredible. Is there anything more glorious than a red maple in the fall? A coral bark maple. It's very small. Very different quality. And this maple is not doing as good. But it's okay.
Okay, so now I'm gonna make the turkey with onions, garlic, a little bit of mushrooms that will go inside the squash. So frying onions first. Okay, so this pie is looking delicious. Oh, so, oh my gosh, look at the sad face. Oh, look at this sad pie. He's so sad.
Staying out late tonight, having a party tomorrow. Do we have enough in there?
Yeah.
I think those are the tenders, though. That's the only problem.
It's okay.
She might need to buy them.
We're gonna have it after.
Okay.
Oh, it's still very warm.
You cut your smiley face.
I did. Probably needed to rest a little bit longer. I finally have time to sit down and have a piece of pie that I made today. We couldn't have it during dinner because it was still warm. So when I was cutting it, it kind of got a little too gooey. It's too early to cut it. And then me and Mila had to go and leave basically right after dinner to go see our friend perform at a theater. It's her friend, so it's like a little kid. So it was really awesome. Watch her perform on stage. And then once we got back home, you know, this is it. We gotta like have a snack and wash up and and then go to bed and read a book. And the kind of the day got away from me. So here it is, 9:30 p.m. and I'm just about to try the pie. So let's check it out. It looks pretty nice. I don't know if I will remake this pie. It's kind of too soupy. Maybe something went wrong. Okay, I know what went wrong. I did not bake it enough. Raw pie dough is a no-go. Okay, so let's finish up the day. Let's go lay down right there. Okay, by the way, what are your thoughts about paint by numbers paintings? I really wanted to do muted colors, beach front sort of
look, and I wanted it to be from Michigan Lake because I'm obsessed with Michigan Lake and really Michigan beautiful scenery, surprisingly, but I wanted to do like a painting of the beach, like the sandy dunes areas and stuff. So I found this one, and obviously it's not finished, but you can see some touches that the direction that it will go into as well. And it is such a peaceful thing to do. Such a peaceful thing to do. I have been working on it for just a couple of days now, but I love every single minute. And ever since I started doing that, my daughter oftentimes sits next to me and also paints, and we just kind of hang out, and it's the cutest thing. Let's call it just a little something I'm trying. And this stand, actually, I got from Hulu. They sent me this gift quite a few years ago, I think like 5 years ago, and it's Bob Ross, The Joy of Painting by Hulu, and it's a whole painting kit with the canvas inside and stuff, so it's like a little suitcase for painting. I have kept it all of these years, and now I pulled it out for this project here, and it works out perfect. How very convenient. So yeah, I really like painting. It's sometimes hard to come up with a plan. It's quite a long process to really create any art. So I really wanted to kind of dip my toes and do it first. All right, so now let's definitely go lay down there and enjoy the rest of the night. Recently I found this guy, this diffuser, and I got obsessed with it. It almost looks like fire, but it's not, obviously. It's so quiet. I'm definitely going to use it in one of my soon-to-come ASMR videos. Because we as a family have been enjoying it so much. It is such a hypnotizing thing. Very soothing and peaceful. Okay, you guys, here we are, cuddling with my huge blanket that weighs like 10 pounds, it feels like. But it's super comfy. So let's see what we have on tea. Okay, so as far as shows go, lately I've been watching this show a lot. I love this one, Life on Planet, on Our Planet. I also watch a lot of cooking shows, even like this at night, I know, right? That's where all the snacking comes from, but that's okay. That's the comforting kind of thing. I sometimes watch trash TV, like The Selling Sunset, Surviving Paradise. I usually start watching them and I just lose my interest very quickly. And I usually turn on a cooking show again. Or like go to YouTube and start watching gardening videos. Or start watching like renovation videos for houses. I think everybody watches it, right? Everyone I know is obsessed with all the house hunter stuff. Anyone who's purchasing like new properties or investments, or just looking at different people's houses. Always very interested and interesting. I talked a lot today. So guys, I wanted to say goodnight to you. And thank you so much for spending a wonderful time with me. It was quite pleasant. It was definitely very soothing and comforting for me, and I hope it was. Do my best and show you things that I enjoy the most, things that bring me comfort, and at that, I'm going to sleep. I'm gonna finish watching these 15 minutes on the episode, and I'm gonna go to sleep. you too. Good night.